What is pen testing? What is bug bounty? And what is pen testing? My professional job is being a penetration tester, but I'm not really a pen tester. I don't like saying I'm a pen tester because then people think I do hacking, when in fact all I do is just test pens. So I need to find another name. Just kidding, it's not April 1st. I want to talk about the difference of pen testing and pen testing, and also how bug bounties fit into that. When I say I do pen testing, what comes to your mind? What do you think I do? I asked this question on Twitter and on the YouTube community tab, and it confirmed what I had guessed. Most people see pen testing to do this red teaming kind of work. Maybe you go on site, you try to hack the company's Wi-Fi. When you got in, you start scanning the network with Nmap and you find some outdated Windows server. So you fire up Metasploit and try some known exploits. In parallel, you run Responder, grab some hashes, try to crack them and pwn the domain admin. At least that's how I think it works, because I have never done this. I have, of course, a bit of experience with that stuff. I did get OSCP in like 2013, but I have actually never used these kind of tools. In my job as a pen tester, I actually do mostly code audits or black box application security tests. So the job looks more like a client develops a website, a native app, or a mobile app, and then they want to know how they stand in terms of security. So we go in, read the code, do dynamic testing, and we use burp and look at the API requests, maybe do some fuzzing, and we find new vulnerabilities that were not known before. Then we gather all our findings and we write a report, including conclusions, how we feel about the overall state of security of this particular application. As you can see, this is very different from the other pen testing. I would even say they are on opposite sides. This pen testing targets a whole corporation, while my pen testing only looks at an individual application. The red teaming pen test might also look for vulnerabilities in the application of the company, but mostly using some automatic scanners like Nessus, and generally only briefly. They have a much larger scope and can't focus on details. Their goal is to hack into the company. While the other side focuses on the app, so it's a lot more detail oriented, and things like the security of the customer data is much more in focus. Oftentimes, pwning a web app doesn't even affect the company's own security at all, because those web apps run on rented servers somewhere. So in some way, you could say this protects the company, while this protects the customers of the company. And just to make this clear, both sides are very important. A company should know how they stand with their corporate security, while a company should also know the security state of their own product. I personally don't like the corporate side much, mostly because you have such a large scope, you cannot focus on details, you must rely on tools, but you have to use those tools well. It's not like you don't need a lot of skills and experience to do that well. It definitely requires skills. But personally, I just like the technical details more. I like to dig deep into an application and uncover weird security issues. I think I also noticed a cultural difference between Europe and the United States. I don't mean to exclude the rest of the world, those are just the people I happen to have the most interaction with. And I feel like in Europe, pen testing much more means this kind of application security focused testing, while in the US, this red teaming is a lot more prominent. I haven't conducted a study, so not sure if that's true, but that's my feeling. And it would correlate with the polling results, as the majority of my audience is from the US. So calling both sides pen testing is a bit unfortunate. We need a different name, and I asked on Twitter what name would describe my job better. Security tester, security analyst, security researcher. But personally, I like application security tester or AppSec tester the most. So going forward in this video, I will keep calling the corporate side pen testing and my job AppSec. If you look at my YouTube channel, by the way, I recently made a video giving an overview of all the topics you can find on my channel, then you will notice I very rarely cover pen testing. I don't think I have a single video where I use Metasploit. I might have used Nmap once, and I have never talked about Active Directory past the hash or using Wi-Fi hacking tools and products. It's just not my world of IT security. I also do a lot of CTF stuff, and CTFs is where I keep up to date with the industry and learn new stuff. But some people say that CTFs are unrealistic, and if you have the point of view from red teaming pen testing, then yes, I would agree. 99% of CTF challenges are way too detail oriented to be useful for a pen tester. But for an application security tester, this detailed orientedness, this focus on small errors, reading and analyzing code, digging deep into the understanding how a certain technology works, that is 100% the work of an AppSec tester. So sometimes I feel like we talk past each other, because when people talk about jobs in IT security, they maybe mean this other side of security, while I mean this side of security. But besides offensive jobs like this, there's also the opposite sides. For example, in pen testing and red teaming, that would be the blue teaming. Then we have jobs like security analysts working in a SOC, a security operations center, or administrators of active directories and so forth. They protect the corporation's own security perimeter. While on the opposite side of AppSec, we have programmers, software engineers, and DevOps that try to write secure applications and protect the customer's data. And now let's think about security education. Learning tools like Metasploit, Nessus, Responder, Wi-Fi hacking, rat implants, and all these things are important skills for this corporate hacking world, but I think that job market is a lot more limited. While on the AppSec side, we have tons and tons of developers. That's also why I think my channel is bigger, because I think my videos are just more applicable to the work of developers. Critically thinking of their own code and how the technologies that they use all the time actually work. And I also think CTFs benefit developers the most. I think you are probably a much more valuable developer if you have a little bit of security mindset when writing code. And I also feel like being a developer or DevOps is a lot closer to my current job doing application security than the pen testing side. I think I personally would rather do software development, hopefully with a bit of focus on security, than doing corporate red teaming pen testing if I had to choose a job. Hopefully it's clear that I don't criticize pen testing. It's a really fun job for many. It's just not what I like to do. Anyway, the title also mentions bug bounty. So how does that fit into this picture? I think bug bounty sits somewhere in the middle of these two worlds. In bug bounty, you also have a large scope and you come from an external point of view. You have to do some scanning and asset discovery, like finding some weird forgotten web app and some subdomains. Some of these applications handle customer data, like in AppSec, but other apps are in the internal corporate world and are only used by the employees. So it covers a bit from both areas. And bug bounties require some knowledge of tools to discover assets, but also require the technical intricacies to dig deep into the behavior of an API and know your way around exploiting application-specific vulnerabilities. I also think the CTF mindset helps for bug bounties a lot, but you're still coming from the outside. Doing pen testing or AppSec closely with a company, you get a lot more information and don't waste much time. For example, I usually get access to the source code, and instead of wasting time brute forcing API endpoints, I can just look up all the configured routes and specifically audit the API endpoints. So application security testing sits a bit earlier in the software development pipeline. You often test on a staging or development build before the code is released in production. Hopefully can catch security issues before customer data might be affected. Or just give the company an overview where they stand security-wise. But even when testing with access to code, nobody can give you a guarantee or certifies that every vulnerability was found. That's why a bigger company like Google also runs a bug bounty program. They have their own internal teams auditing code. It's important to do this application security work, ideally before it hits production, but bugs will be missed. And then maybe bug bounty hunters find that stuff later. Or not, they can also miss stuff. Anyway, I hope these few thoughts helped you to get a better overview of the different areas of IT security work and helps you better focus on what you should learn for the job that you are interested in.